Hey everybody, hope y'all are doing all right. It's been a while since I streamed last. It's been kind of crazy. I did that big huge update post, and I've been reworking the UI and stuff. You'll see some of that here. Some of it's still being developed. You can see the prep stations look a little different. A lot of the stuff is the same, but I think it's kind of heightened by the new design. I don't know. I like it. But we'll see. I think it's an improvement at least. Like, you'll see that this part right here is the new UI, but this top part and this bottom part is still the old UI. So I still got some work to do. This is still the old recipe thing, and yeah, so it's going. But as always, this is a work in progress. One thing that I did do between streams is one of the last major prep stations that I haven't done yet. You know, I have, this was the hardest one to do, the deep fryer. And the second hardest one that I had to do was the stove. So here's how it's looking so far. So I have the flames dancing right there, and I got the water boiling, smoke rising. I did all that, and then I forgot that chow mein isn't boiled, it's put in a pan. Oops. So I gotta change this to like macaroni or something. But in the original Cooks Are Delicious, the pot was at an angle to where you only saw stuff drop in, because I thought it would be very difficult to put stuff in the pot. I didn't know how to do that. So now I'm kind of just, I kind of have to do it now. I want to show players what they're putting in the pot. And so it's going to be real neat once I get it working. You're going to see the soup fly in there, and it's going to be floating. And I don't know. I like the little flames that are dancing. This took me like a day to do, but that actually didn't take me as long as I thought it was going to take me. And the nice thing is, you'll see on this one, I'm only using one side of the prep station. I'm thinking what I'm going to do is, like, for pasta, like in the first game, you would boil the pasta, but then in the next stage, you would already have the hamburger meat or the meatballs, and you would just put it on the pasta, and there was no prep phase for that. I'm thinking maybe you could boil some pasta right here, and then on the other one there could be like a... I can't remember what you call it. What's that thing you use to cook with? I can't remember. It's called a pan thing. You can put meat on it and stuff. I don't know. It would be a little more complex, but it would make a little more sense. Anyway. So yeah, we'll see how that goes. I don't think this works. Yeah, it doesn't work. I don't know. It's going. So this was the second most complicated thing I had to do. And then a lot of it's downhill from here, I hope. So today I wanted to do some... I wanted to finish up what I did last time I streamed, which was some... gosh, what did I do? Tiramisu. That sounds good to me. Because I don't think I have that here. Yeah. Oh boy. So I have the old game maker. I'm still using this. I'm going to take a break for the holidays. Take a break from streaming and updates and stuff. And during that time, I'll be porting this game over to Game Maker Studio 2. I'm going to learn Game Maker Studio 2, and the next time I stream after the holidays will hopefully be in that program instead of this one. But for now, we're going to just use Game Maker 1.4. So I'm going to get started. Also, if it looks like I'm kind of flailing around, I have to remember what I did a few weeks ago, because I was very sick and I wasn't all there, and I kind of have to remember where I left off. I think everything's in, though. It shouldn't be too big a deal.
Let's go.
All right. Here's a new track that I got the other day for Cook Serve Delicious 2. Let's see here. Oh boy, yeah, Jonathan Geer, that's the composer. He's doing amazing work. I will do one more. I'm going to do a new Rush Hour track. Oh boy. And then right after all that action-packed music, then you just go back to this. Oh wait, not that one. There we go, that one. Or any random one of these, actually. Well, since I played a part of another gameplay track, I guess I'll play that one next. Man, I love these chill tracks. Basically, I gave my composer a bunch of Sims music and all kinds of music that I love, a lot of it that you're hearing on my playlist, and kind of told him, I want this. And he's doing great work. I love it. There's a lot of tracks. There's going to be, I'm thinking about 20 gameplay tracks and 6 or 8 Rush Hour tracks. And then a lot of music outside of that. There's going to be menu music. And then the main theme, which I had a meeting with the composer about this week, kind of figure out what we're going to do. Because that's important. I think the first one has a crazy title theme, and I don't know. I don't know what exactly we're going to do. We have some ideas, so that's going to be fun. Anyway, hope you all enjoyed that. I got to get back to programming.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Well, all right, everyone. That's going to do it for today's stream. Hope y'all enjoyed it. Got a lot done today. Next week, I'm going to try and stream before Christmas, probably early in the week. But if I don't, then I'm probably going to break for Christmas. And during that time, I'm going to be porting the game over to GM Studio 2 and trying to learn it over the holiday break. And then I'll come back and have a whole new program that I'm working on or working using. From what I've used, it's amazing. I can't wait to move just to it completely. And that's the plan. But yeah, hopefully I will stream next week. If I don't, y'all have a good holiday. Merry Christmas. Happy New Year. And we'll see y'all later. Mom,